Welcome back to Let's Play Populous. I'm about to do world 143 called Alpkeed. Or, if you prefer, Alpseed, because it is with a C. I don't know whether the C is a soft C or a hard C. Either way works. Anyway, I can just do Knights and Volcanoes. So first things first, put him on there. Build a castle as soon as possible, like that. Good, he's going in a good direction. That's it, good. Build a castle out of him. One more movement. That's it, good. He's going the wrong way. Oh, forget about him. I would help you if I could, believe me. Not allowed to yet. Nope. It's painful, really. I have to watch him die. Nope, good. Right. What happened to the other one? Where is he? He's gone down there. Oh, he's alright now. Good. Right, you can stay there as well. Right. Let's put a castle out of this one. Get him out, go to Bubble Magnet to make sure he goes in the right direction. And when he's past that bit, then put on Settle. That's it, good. Stay there. That's it, a lot of rocks here. Get rid of that. One more, there we go. You can usually see when they build what building actually does when they have too much population to settle in the house they build, is it splits them up. Every time they build and they walk away, they're depositing some of their population into the house. And that's what when they fight and win a house as well. They cancel out population with the one they fought and won, if they did win, and then they deposit some of the population. And if they don't have enough population to deposit, then they settle into the settlement they built or they won. Because all walkers are representations of population. The more population they have, the more strength they have, and the more settlements they can build without settling. Because a castle, a settlement number 9, can hold much more population than any of the others. To build one of those and walk away requires a lot of... because you have to deposit a lot of population in them to walk away. Right, so what I'm going to do in this one, and all the worlds hopefully, is I'm not going to do any powers like earthquakes or swamps unless absolutely necessary, and knights either unless absolutely necessary. I'm just going to get up to Armageddon. Oh, need we do that? Get up to Armageddon as fast as possible, and while I'm trying to get up to Armageddon, I'll invade them, and depending on which one I achieve first, whether I get up to Armageddon or win the world first, it doesn't matter. In other words, I'm going to complete the world as quickly as I can. If I can do Armageddon, that's the best, because then I jump the most worlds, as you know, which is stupid. Right, that'll do. Get that down. A few more rocks. As soon as I get rid of these rocks, I'll put it on Go to Purple Magnet. Right, Bird Above Magnet. Where is he? He's in there. Right, to put this down over here. Put it in there. Put castle. That's it, good. Where is he? Get some more castles down for him. There we go, good. Oh, I have to put on fight or something. Nope. He won easily. Alright. As soon as he gets over here, immediately put it in here. That's it. Hit these castles. Actually, I'll just put on fight and settle. There you go, get the strength out, and just leave it on fight and settle, because they are actually building very fast now. This looks like I won't be able to win by invasion. I'll have to wait for Armageddon, which is good really. Get these down. That was close, just rescued him. Where is he? Good. What's he doing? So I just wanted to go for the houses. If the houses are important, but it's annoyingly just going after the people. Oh, for heaven's sake. Very frustrating, very, very frustrating. He doesn't do anything. Do something. Just get a house, any house. Watch him change his mind. No, he's actually. So you only get a person out as soon as he comes, just to be annoying, because it takes longer then. That's it, get it out. Make some makeshift volcanoes, but not using any mana, you see. Good, his leader dead. Good, another castle. And he's actually lost all his strength now. Come on, get him. I want someone to get that one and this one. Right, good, I'm actually winning a few castles here. So I don't want more people, I want. I don't want them to make more people. There he is. Right. Do something. Please do something, for heaven's sake. It's one annoying thing about this game. You're not given many options to command them. They just sort of walk around randomly. So they're all going after him now. I don't want him. He's useless. You see, it's just useless. I want the house. That's it. I'll get that one. It's the house I want. Oh, it's just changed direction. It's going after a person now. They're going after him and they can't get him. It, fight it. Next one. No, fight him. He's being annoying. Fight that one. Yes, him. And then go and get the house. That's it. Good. 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 Look at those mountains down I created. Nearly up to Armageddon now, so I'll get it off right and settle. I might as well. It took me 12 minutes to do this world. See, anywhere they can build a little colony, they will. Any little space, you have to get rid of every last one. He was that one. He thought that one was going for this one. He only fought that one by luck. Armageddon. As soon as you can. Rocks I never got rid of over there. Why did he do that? I'm glad he did though. Bing Q me. 150. Futuristic, just floods. Right. I won't put it on two levels. Right, make a castle immediately. They won't perish very quickly, so I can just concentrate on one house at a time. You won't put it on two levels, it will take too long and use too much mana. If they do a flood, so be it. Because the drown rate is very low. Alright, as many castles as you can. Alright, where's the rest of them go? There's one over there. Where's he going? Build there, or there if you want. Good there. So they need to start increasing in population when they're settled, otherwise they lose population slowly by perishing. Right, any more? Right, any more? No, that's it. So get him out. No, he won't come out. Let me see where he will now. No, he's gone back in. Alright, follow him. Where's he going? completely wrong direction and now he's gone crazy. Oh no, he hasn't. Annoyingly placed rock there, that prevented him from building there. Very annoying. Right. Get them all out. And him. More people out, the better. Get all these rocks down. Where's he gone? He's built, right? Get that rock. He's still moping around. Get these two out. You can't build there because of these annoying rocks. You can't build next to... Oh, who's... Right, let's get rid of him. Someone kill him. I don't care who, just someone get rid of him. Not that I want to kill their leader because it would be more annoying, but I've got a reward for it. But he'll start a colony, and then it'll be even more tricky trying to get rid of the colony, so just... nip him in the bud. So I treat him like any other evil walker, really. All these rocks, like a volcano, it's not fair. Alright, sorted here, I got some reward mana for that. It jumped me straight to middle earthquake. The middle of earthquake, I mean. Not an earthquake in middle earth. All that load of rubbish. Bored of the rings. Even though it should be bored with the rings, but anyway. Actually, I have something to say about that, actually. They always have to turn every film into a trilogy to make as much money from it as possible. Turn it into a trilogy. And with this new Hobbit thing, turning that into a trilogy as well. And all the idiots will go and, will go and see it. There's that annoying bloke from The Office in it. He plays the same character every time. Always has that annoyed look on him. As if he's just been offended and he doesn't know what to say. What's his name? Matt Freeman, that's it. Yeah. No, not Matt Freeman. Martin Freeman, that's the one. Yeah, Martin Freeman always plays the same character in everything he ever does. Remember in the Office special features, he starts boasting that he's a classically trained actor, and that's why Ricky Gervais was trying to put him off and make him laugh during scenes in the Office, during filming scenes in the Office. Because he's a classically trained actor. The egos of these people is just amazing. They just love bigging themselves up. And they've chosen him to play the Hobbits. That's millions of pounds in his pocket, because loads of people will go to see it. And they're doing a trilogy. So it goes on. Then I'll do another trilogy, a spin-off, then probably a TV series from it. And then loads of computer game rights and blah blah blah. You know the story. Right. Enough of my moaning. If you have any thoughts or opinions of what I just said, please feel free to leave a comment. Although no abusive ones. You know, if you disagree with what I say, then do it politely. Otherwise you'll be deleted. Everyone's free to disagree, but no one's free to be abusive about it. But Lord of the Rings and The Hobbit and Martin Freeman are completely a no-no in my book. Well, like Harry Potter. Don't get me started on Harry Potter. Right. Right. I'm getting a few of my castles. Yeah, they've won a few of them. Get them down. Let's just leave it on settle and just get them up. That. He's going after that one, isn't he? No, he's not. Let's get this down. Just a sec. There you go. Won a castle. No, they built that. Get that. Oh. No, he didn't fight him. This is all right, invasion by stealth. Should just swamp him. Obviously attempting an invasion. No, it still won't work. One more, there we go, finally. Let him get this stupid leader. Lots of trees. Nearly won this. Hope I get up to Armageddon before they do a flood. Oh, it's that. Fall in it. Do it now. I've never had that happen to me, do Armageddon and then all my people fall in one swamp. I've never had that happen. Wait. Good. Mining hole. Jumped 5 from that, so I can just do knights. Should be easy. And they can't do anything. Alright, sorted. Get him to go forward. And again. One more. Oh, good. Another one. Get this one to go forward. Once more. That'll do. One over here. Worst place you could have gone. Oh dear. It's quite unfortunate that. Nothing I can do. Absolutely nothing. I'm powerless. Just wait for him to die. Oops. Down here. of trees there. Nope, missed a chance. Nothing they can do, so that they just try to create a strong leader with which to invade. Just get up to Armageddon as quickly as possible. They're trying to invade now. They're following the leader. Where is he? Yeah, there he is. I'll see if I can kill him without swamping him, actually, just for a laugh. There's a lot of strength in these men. They will knock a chunk out of him. Nearly won. There we go, that's it, end of that. So invasion stopped. Going after this one, and he'll lose. Armageddon. It just us hole jumped 7 there. They can't do floods and I can't do earthquakes, both start with 15. Is that taken care of? Loads over here. Decide which one to turn into a castle, this one. Next. If you'd lost, I'd have been in trouble. Get rid of that house over there. Yeah, there's loads of strength. Wrong way. A bit closer. Good. We've started. That was a good run. it's over here. Yeah, the screen, the world map seems to go green a bit when an earthquake happens. It's weird. If you look closely at the world map, when an earthquake happens, it's like green. Put that down. And again. Down a bit. There you go. Oh good, they've got rid of those rocks for me. Pause it and find their leader. Yep, they're trying to invade. Easy swamp. Done. Deal that late, it's not a problem. I think it was over here. If you just look at the world map and see if there's some, as soon as a swamp happens, if any blue dots, that means people have come out of some houses because of the swamp, and that might give you a clue. That's, other than that, if you want to find it, just pause it and press the find settlement there, the find fight button, until you come upon a house that's next to them. That's what I do. If you want to find them, do that and that. It's going to take a long time. Do some volcanoes. Do another one. can't be asked to get that down. Armageddon. Have a castle, yeah. See, that's what happens when you come out of a castle naturally. You have that amount of strength and you leave a person in there, leave loads of population in there. Oh, I can't be bothered to wait. That's the last of their population. He actually might win that next turn. Nope. Can't be bothered to wait for Armageddon. Right, more or less. 170. It's not too bad. Futuristic, very low, and everything. Over there. Right. Sort him out first. There we go. Move forward a bit. Get that top person out. So he goes in the right direction. Good. There's that other one. What was he doing over there? How did he get over there? Good. Someone might have been drowning in it. Yep. Near the earthquake, a little pool, there's usually someone drowning in it. It's unbelievable. And he wants to go over there, yep. To just get it off right and settle and put it back to settle. I hate it when they start a little colony. Go away. Too many of them. The volcano. No one in them. Lost it. That one as well. Good. What's that one? Want a castle there. God for that, send to them. You'll lose that. No, he just won. Way. Wait for Armageddon. Oh, they managed to win that castle. Swamp him. Nope. Got him. Wait for Armageddon now. one more. There we go. There are a few tricky worlds in the 200, so hopefully I'll be able to have a few challenging ones in that one in the next few videos. There we go. Im die out. 177. Ooh, this is a challenging one. No, 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 and yes, 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 yes. So I can't do anything. Im die out, remember that one. And I'll do that next time. See you then. Bye-bye.